friends, what's up? Today I am starting the vlog off. It's 2 o'clock. I was at my parents' house for a little bit. Parents' house, my house. I should say my house because my mom and dad tell me every house is everyone's house, if that makes sense. But I just easier for me to say parents' house because then you guys can differentiate which house I was at, if that makes sense. I'm actually about to leave. We're gonna head back downtown and I'm gonna stop at No Frills or Walmart. I'm still trying to decide. I might go to Walmart and finally restock the fridge because I want to like meal prep and stuff. I was doing great when I did the last meal prep a few vlogs ago. I showed you guys I like had cut the chickens into packets and stuff, so I'm gonna redo that
because it makes life so much easier when you're prepared food wise that I don't have to think about anything and cooking stuff. It's just ready to go. So I'm gonna make a few different dishes today and just take the time to be prepared for the week, and then we are good to go. So yeah, let's head downtown and then I will see you guys when I get to Walmart. I didn't film when I was in Walmart just because, I don't know, because of COVID, it's just like, I don't want to film, you know, because I feel like people are already on edge and then filming makes them more on edge. All right, I got a bunch of things. So I'll let you guys first know what they are, and then we will also put them away together because this house is really quiet. So I know a lot of you, well, a few, I saw 2 comments saying that I should have kept a TV down here because when I'm here like cooking and stuff, it'll be nice to have like something to watch. And then also if people would, nobody really comes over besides my own family, but that way I won't have to take food upstairs and eat, if that makes sense, which is totally true. I'm still probably gonna get a TV for here. One that's like not too big, just like, you know, fits it, and that way I can watch TV while I'm cooking, or if the whole family's here we can kind of just all chill together and cook and watch TV and whatever. But obviously that'll all come when the house is fully furnished. It's not furnished yet, and I think Sana and I are going to start the process probably like next week. So I'll keep you guys in the loop, and then I'll have like a video showing you how I decorate. Anyways, I went to Walmart, I got a bunch of things that we will go through. I got a lot of groceries and then also some cleaning supplies and some toilet stuff. We'll just go through groceries first. Okay, so the first thing I got were these express lasagna, what are called, strips, because recently, I don't know if you guys saw on my mom's channel, she made lasagna soup, which it's basically kind of like a chili but with lasagna pieces in it. Go watch that video if you haven't, because it's so good. So I want to recreate it, but I want to make it, I want to track the macros for it. So I'm going to make it myself. I might make it today or tomorrow. Either way, you guys will see when I make it. I got fruit roll-up because Sana likes these, and then we always have them at home, and then I always take one and they're really good. So I'm like, okay, why not? Then I got sour cherry blasters. I'm all about eating healthy and all about health, but like, you know, I still need a snack here and there. Oh my god, actually, hold on, before I forget, I got so much ice cream and they're probably all melted. Oh no. So I got, oh no, these melt so fast. So we got these mini drumsticks, this flavor, and then if you guys haven't tried Milona, they're so good. And they're Milona's, I know for sure, are melted because they're not like, they're kind of like a gelato. Oh yeah, they're soft. So Milona's are kind of like a gelato, so they're already very soft, and then when they start melting, they literally start dripping. So I'm just gonna put these. Then I got these broccoli florets or whatever. They're they're already like pre-cut. Makes my life so much easier. I got lazy. I would normally go to a meat shop and get all my meat, but like I just said, very, very lazy. So I got 3 of these halal green lean ground beef packets. So I got 1, 2, 3. We're actually gonna keep these out because I'm probably gonna meal prep them today and at least put them into like pre-measured baggies. So I got 5 of these because it was 5 for $10, and normally I think they're about almost $3 or $4 each. So I got 5. Ugh. The lady who was packing my bags, I know this because my first job was at Walmart, and they put you through like these tests and training lessons that tell you how to bag
groceries, and the wrong way to bag it is to put one, two, three, four, five glass bottles in one bag. Just saying. Okay, anyway, so I got five of those, and I got the four cheese, and then I also got the roasted garlic and onion, and then I got some hot salsa, and then I got this. It's a dilly dip dressing. It's I guess it's dill dressing. I really like dill flavor. I don't know why. I think it's just like it because it's like super jutpata or whatever. Crushed tomato can, because somehow I always end up needing it. And then I got two coconut water cans. I normally get the one that's in like the paper packing, but they only had these today, and coconut water is delicious. Then I got a cabbage, because I might be making those noodles I always make, and I need cabbage for that, and then also for my soup that I'm gonna make. I also got mushrooms. These are to go into the lasagna thing. I love mushrooms so much. And then I got a cucumber, because I have hummus in the fridge. Then I got Babybel cheese. And then I got Dairy Milk buttons. I got two green peppers, a pack of carrots, two strawberry Greek yogurts, because they're delicious and they're high in protein. I usually put raspberries in it, but I picked up raspberries and then I noticed when I was at the checkout that they were molding, and I put them back. And then I got the Greek, just plain Greek yogurt as well. I don't know if your guys' dad, or if it's like a Pakistani dad thing, but my dad always takes yogurt and he puts sugar in it and lets it dissolve, and it tastes so good. So sometimes I like to do that with fruit. It's really good. It's really delicious. You guys have to try it. Then I got some regular cheese sticks and some shredded cheese. So next, I picked up this, the Downy Unstoppable In Wash, like the scent booster thing. This smells like really good, so I got that. Then I picked up these garbage bags, because I have that drawer that is an actual garbage bin, and I needed like the liners to put in it. And then I got 1, 2, 3 hand soaps, because I have 1, 2, 3 washrooms that I need hand soaps in. It was so much easier before. I only had one washroom and nothing else to worry about, but now I need to make sure they're all good. I also got 3 toilet cleaner brushes. So I don't think you want to see that. That's like literally right in my feet. Then I got these. So I don't know if these actually work, but these are the scrubbing bubble toilet cleaning gels. And you kind of just like, I don't think you guys want to see in a toilet, but I am going to try and put these. Just because you guys know there's like that blue thing that you can put in a toilet, like the back of the toilet, you lift it up and you put that blue thing and it makes your water blue. I got that from my last place, and it didn't really work, and it got stuck to the actual container of the toilet, and I had to scrape it off. It just didn't work well. It was weird and it was all slimy. So this one just goes on your actual toilet bowl. So I'm gonna see if it works, and it smells really good. Like I can already smell it outside of this. We'll see, maybe not. Maybe I show you, maybe I don't. I don't know. We'll see. I got one of these because Sana actually bought this for our home, and then it's so much easier because you just put the dishwashing liquid in here, and then that way you don't get your hands wet and you can scrub it up in your dishes. I got another toilet bowl cleaner because this place, actually nobody lived in it, has lived in it for the last year since it was being built, and then no one lived in it. So then the toilets, since nobody was here living, they got like hard water stains like in the toilet bowl. So before I put the scrubbing bubble thing, I actually have to scrape out and clean. Why? You know what I mean. I have to just clean the toilets, okay? Then I got this Mr. Clean Clean Freak Deep Cleaning Mist. It looks like this. I will use it for some kind of cleaning. And then I got these stainless steel things because I know you're not supposed to like scrub your pots and pans, but let's be real, sometimes you actually need to scrub it. This is just regular dishwashing liquid. We're almost done. Then I got two of these bigger pots because I always find that I'm running, not pots, like little containers. I always find that I'm running out of containers. So I got two of those. And then these for the kitchen, like just regular kitchen towels, bar mop kitchen towels. There's a pack of four. And then I got two of just regular kind of black towels because I have a powder room that downstairs that doesn't have a towel yet. And then also the washroom that's on the middle floor doesn't have a towel. So I just need to make sure everything is stocked. But like I said, it was a lot easier before when I just had to worry about one washroom. I'm very thankful and really excited that I have multiple washrooms I can now decorate, but I never know like what I need. Oh, and then the last thing, I got a pack of chicken.
Okay, first things first, let me see if the garbage bags I got will be big enough for this garbage. Oh yeah, they'll be big enough, I think so. So there's really some shit in here that I'll probably get rid of. I don't know why, but there's a rock in here. And then I got these. I got the size tall. So I hope it'll be okay. I didn't want to get something that, oh yeah, these will be perfect, I think. I don't want to get something too big. And these are the kind that are like a little stretchy. Okay. Oh yeah, this will be perfect. Perfect. Got it in here. And now I can start using this as an actual garbage can. Great, good to go. And then I'll just store the rest of these under my sink. All right, now let's get to putting away all of this stuff. So let's start off with these little kitchen towels. Anyways, what else is new, guys? Thank you for all the love that you've been showing me on all of my moving vlogs and the entire family, really. But I really appreciate it. I think I'll do, this is kind of cute, so I'll do these. What else is new otherwise? We're just living. Is that how it goes? Or is it like, do I like fold it in half? Because I will see my mom does it and she folds them in half and then puts them here. Ooh. Oh, you guys can't even see. Ooh. And then I'll do the same. And then I have two extras. Because these get dirty really quick. Because I'll be honest, sometimes I'll be cooking and my hand gets dirty. And then I'll just like wipe my hand on one of them. And then I'm like, oh shit, I got them dirty. Perfect. So that's there. And then these two I'll just put somewhere for extraness. So I guess we can do the fridge next. Which I'm sorry that the lighting is a little yellow. Can't really change it because it's weird. But you guys can see in the fridge. Okay. So let's put away the things in the fridge that I know I'm not really gonna use right now and keep everything that I'm gonna use out. Or at least like put them away until, you know. So I'll put my vegetables here just because why not? And then this place, I already have this section here. I think I showed you guys last time. This little section that I keep all the drinks in. So I'm just gonna pop the coconut water in there also. Might as well. This is the box that I normally drink. And so we got two of those. Why is this lighting so off? Better, but still yellow. Then I got some Greek yogurt. I'll put here. And then I'll put my other Greek yogurt, the strawberry one, right in front or behind it. And then what else needs to go in the fridge? All my cheeses. I got my cabbage that I'll put in here. Cause I don't know exactly what I'm making today, but I'll figure it out. My green peppers, carrots. I just wanna be neater than I was the last time and only take the vegetables that I know will not go bad because I learned that so many times the hard way cause you think you're gonna eat a lot of these vegetables and then it goes bad. And then I was like, wow, now I know why my mom's always telling me we make food go bad because it goes bad so quick. It goes bad in like 2 days. My chicken breast and my actual beef that I'm not gonna put in the fridge just because I'm gonna pre-packet those and freeze them right away. But what I will do is this cabinet right here is like my snack drawer. So I'll put all my fruit roll-ups and my chocolate and candies in there. And then the past
See, now I'm trying to decide what I want to make today. I think I might just make the lasagna soup because I'm craving it. Yeah, I think we'll do that. But what I'm going to do is only make like enough for me to last today. So for that, I'm going to leave out this. I'm going to leave out one can of my sauce and put away the rest. So for pasta sauce and stuff, I've just been keeping it right here under my microwave. So I'm just keeping all my canned goods and extra like sauces here. Even though I feel like I should even maybe keep it down there where I put the extra pasta itself and rice. But I'm too lazy to go down there right now. We're done with the things here. The only thing that I need to keep here is this. We might as well. If that like noise is here, I'm sorry, I don't know. I'm trying to pinpoint exactly where, like what causes it to do that. Push tab up, push forward to remove. What tab? Oh, I broke it. That's great. Oh, I broke it for real, for real. I literally, why do they make the tab so delicate? I can't even fill it and use it. That's some bullshit. Okay, whatever, I'll throw it out. I know I can keep this and just buy refills of this. Man, whatever, it's fine. The tab, you guys saw that. I did not press too hard. For now, I'll just leave it up here, it's fine. What else do I need to leave here? The dishwashing soap can stay here, and these will go upstairs and stuff in the washrooms. I kind of want to smell them because I might want to keep the good one down here. Like I might want to keep, this one is argan oil. This one is fresh water. Not bad. But this one, I feel like I'm going to like because it's coconut milk and I love anything coconut. Doesn't really smell like, it's like a very mild coconut, but it's okay, I'll keep it. First thing that I'm gonna do is packet out all of my meats because why not? I had Ziplocs here, hold on. Gonna wash my hands and packet out all my meats. So I'm gonna do 6 ounce packets of my beef and then also 6 ounce packets of my chicken. It's really boring and straightforward. And of course, like if you guys have different dietary needs, you can do that. But I found that 4 ounces is too little in terms of protein, and then 8 ounces is too much. So I think 6 is like a good number for me. So I'm hoping I can get out at least like 10. We'll see. I think these, I already calculated the beef is gonna get broken into about 8 packets, and then we'll figure out the chicken after. So let me wash my hands. And then I'm gonna get to packing all of this meat. I'm gonna watch some YouTube in the meantime. Also gonna put on my mouth guard because my jaw, I think, is the reason why I'm having a headache. So my mouth guard's over there, but it's like really gross and not cute to look at. So you guys don't need to see that. I'll talk to you guys when the meat is done. All right, so meat is done being packed. All of these, they're both 6 ounces each. I think for today, I might only use 2 of these. I'm trying to decide if I want to make like just for today or I want to make it extra and then freeze the rest. I'm going to try to figure that out. But I know chicken I'm not going to use today at all, so I'm going to put them in the freezer and get that done with.
Oh, my eyes. Okay, so my eyes. Okay, so I'm gonna tweak my mom's recipe a little bit just because, oh my god, my eyes are burning so bad. Just because, why am I tweaking her recipe? Because I just like plugged everything into my Fitness Pal. I had to take my ponytail guys down because like my hair, my head was like really hurting. So let me just tie my hair a little bit. So I have a pot ready to go. And in the pot, I'm gonna just put like a teaspoon or a teaspoon and a half of oil. But like I said, I'm just tweaking my mom's recipe. If you guys want like the really like full recipe, just go on her channel and watch it because she gives it to you and it's so yummy. And it's like, it tastes just like lasagna basically, but without the layers. So I guess it doesn't taste just like lasagna, but it has the flavoring in it. But I'm just tracking all my macros. So I'm only gonna put 2.5 pieces of lasagna into my water once it starts boiling. But what I'm going to do is also just put in my onions. Just gonna let those start sauteing a little bit. And then I'm just gonna spin it around up here.
That's going, my water's boiling. And then in terms of my veggies, I am gonna put a decent amount of mushrooms, probably the half of this packet, and then probably half a green pepper. Our favorite, or my favorite at least, vegetable to put the two veggies to put into lasagna is green peppers and mushrooms. And I know I always see all the comments of people saying that lasagna is only made if you put like white sauce in it. We tried that and it wasn't good. And I didn't say I was making authentic Italian lasagna. This is just like how I prefer to eat my pastas, with a little bit different flavor. Something that I guess it just depends on what ethnicity or what your flavor palette is, because we prefer when it has a little bit more of a desi flavor rather than a white sauce. It's a little plain. But sometimes, I mean, I get it. I'm sure if I tried the other one, I would like it, but this is just the one that I like best, you know? Peppers, I'm happy I got that meat done with, because now I have no excuse to eat out, because honestly, I've just been ordering Uber Eats since I moved here, anytime I've been staying, because I've just been using the excuse that I don't have any groceries. So today I was like, all right, let me at least go get some groceries. Would it work if I got fresh garlic and then I peeled them all and put it in an airtight like mason jar? Would that work? Because I do like when I use like fresh garlic compared to the ginger and garlic paste. I feel like the flavor is a lot better, but it's just like annoying to do as like the day of. So if I can do that, I will do that. Just gonna pop in my garlic, and then once that's done, I'm gonna put in the beef as well. I just wait for the onions to go in first. Anyways, what else? I'm feeling good today because I'm tracking all of my food back to normal. I just feel like there's some type of normalcy, I guess you could say. I don't know what's happening, but I think gyms were supposed to open back up on Saturday, which is in just like a few days. Today is Wednesday, but, or Tuesday, today's Tuesday. But I don't know what's happening because cases are still going up. So I don't know if gyms are not gonna open now, or like what's gonna go on. I have no idea. I kind of hope they open up, but like, I mean, obviously it's understandable if for health and safety reasons we can't, but like I just feel like I won't be able to have a like feel normal and have a normal routine in this house until they do open up, just because like I've been going home back to Mississauga every day anyway because everyone's there, and plus the garage gym is there, so I know at least I can use that. And then in my head I'm like, okay, well why am I driving from Toronto to Mississauga every single day when I can just stay there and not waste gas, because my Jeep freaking just like drinks gas like it's water. But then now I obviously bought this place and I have a mortgage and shit. So I don't know, I'm like in limbo, if that makes sense. I really like when my beef is like super like broken up. I don't like big chunks of beef. I'm not like a beef fan in general. I prefer chicken or like white meat, I guess you can say. But if I am having it, I want to make sure it's like in small pieces and not like overly chunky. So I'm cooking it on high, and then I'm basically just gonna eyeball the rest. I have some pasta sauce that I'm gonna put in, and then I'm gonna put more water. Honestly, I don't know when you guys stopped recording, but I just put the beef in the oven, and now I'm just gonna wait for it to cook. I'm cooking it on high, and then I'm also gonna boil these. I'm only gonna boil them about halfway because then we'll transfer them into like the lasagna soup and let them cook all the way over. So I added some chili flakes, garlic powder, also some oregano into this. Once again, you guys can, you know, put in whatever you want. I also put some chili flakes. And now I'm just gonna put in a cup of this pasta sauce. My mom used marinara sauce, which I should have just gotten the plain marinara sauce, because I feel like that tastes good. I mean, obviously this will taste good too, but I feel like the calories in there might be less, but no problem. I'm gonna put in one cup of this, and then I'm also going to put in two of the chicken bouillon cubes. Oh, I might just put one actually. It might get too salty if I put two. So I'm only gonna put in one. Then, I think my mom had added it with water. I'm watching her YouTube video at the same time.
I'm adding half a teaspoon.
Okay, so she put a little bit of water. So I'm gonna pop that in there. And then she also put in half a teaspoon of salt.
I have 1 teaspoon.
Oops, she meant half a teaspoon of black pepper and 1 teaspoon of salt. So it's good I only put half of that.
1 teaspoon Memphis Worcestershire sauce. 1 tablespoon.
I don't have the Worcestershire sauce. Maybe I do.
I don't think I do.
Oh my god, I do! I do have Worcestershire sauce. Since when did this go in here? Oh my god, I'm only gonna put in a little bit because I don't trust this flavoring of this. Okay. But when my mom made it, it was like really good, so I don't know. Some dry basil. Just gonna eyeball this because I feel like basil tastes like really good in pastas. So now I'm just gonna put this on like a low simmer. Let it just chill there, and then wait till my lasagna's cooked through, and then go on. Yeah. Pasta's basically done. It probably needs maybe a few more minutes, but I want to let the rest of it happen in the pan, the pot itself. So what I'm gonna do is bring it out of this, put it on my cutting board, chop it up into smaller pieces, like smaller chunks that'll fit into my spoon, and then we're gonna pop it into the other pot. And the reason why I'm just not dumping it out is because I actually want to use this pasta water. Do I say pasta wrong? People say it's pasta. Anyway, so I'm gonna dump there's not too much water, but I'm gonna dump at least half of it into the thing, and I'm gonna put it back on a level where it can simmer some more. Let me show you how it looks, and then I'm gonna put you on charge. This is how it's looking. I'm gonna let it simmer. I'm actually gonna add more water. As you guys can see, it's too many ingredients in there. So I'm gonna put in more water, let it be more soupy, like so. And now I'm just gonna let it simmer. I think I feel like I should have put more beef, but it's fine. Oh my god. So I just want to show you guys how nice and thick it got. I honestly could have left more water, but it looks so good. I'm so excited to eat all of this. And with that, I'm calling it a night.